A very good morning everyone. Welcome to Alonel Classes. This is me, Mrs. Amrita, your English literature teacher. Today I'll be starting with the prose section, chapter B. Wordsworth. This chapter is taken from your books, Echoes, a collection of ISE short stories, and it's written by V.S. Naipaul. You can see he is V.S. Naipaul. Before starting the story, I would like to tell you about the background of the story. This story is about friendship between two people. However, the age group is quite huge, but still the bond, affection, love between both of them is very pure and strong. Basically, there are two characters in the story. Number one is a poet whose name is B. Wordsworth. B stands for black. Number two is a boy whose name is not mentioned in the story, but the poet calls him Sonny out of love and affection. So here I start with the text. Three beggars called punctually every day at the hospitable houses in McGill Street. At about 10, an Indian came in his dhoti and white jacket, and we poured a tin of rice into the sack he carried on his back. At 12, an old woman smoking a pipe came, and she got a cent. At 2, a blind man led by a boy called for his penny. So here the narrator is remembering his boyhood days, and he says that his house was located in the McGill Street, and it was very famous for the hospitality. Hospitality means the friendly and generous reception and entertainment of guests, visitors or strangers. That is, if any visitor or a stranger came to their house asking for something, they were never returned barehanded. Rather, they were given some or the other thing. So, like that way, one day at about 10, an Indian came to their place. He was wearing a dhoti and a white jacket, and they gave him a tin of rice which was poured by them into his sack which he was carrying on his back. Then at around 12, an old woman smoking a pipe came to their house and she got a cent. Cent is a monetary unit. Then at around 2, a blind man with the help of a boy came to their place and he too asked for his penny. Penny is also a monetary unit. Sometimes we had a rogue. One day a man called and said he was hungry. We gave him a meal. He asked for a cigarette and wouldn't go until we had lit it for him. That man never came again. Sometimes we had a rogue. Rogue means dishonest or unprincipled man. It was like sometimes very weird sort of people also visited their place. So likewise, a man came to their place one day and he said that he was hungry. So they gave him the food, and after eating the food, he demanded for a cigarette. They provided him a cigarette also, but he was not going until they had lit it for him. So it was a weird activity, but after that, that man never came to their place again. The strangest caller came one afternoon at about 4 o'clock. I had come back from school and was in my home clothes. The man said to me, "Sonny, may I come inside your yard?" He was a small man and he was a tidily dressed man. He wore a hat, a white shirt and black trousers. So one day a very strange caller came to their place. It was around 4 o'clock and the narrator was back from school and he was in his normal casual home clothes. That is, he was not in the uniform, rather he was in his home clothes. The man asked the boy and called him, "Sonny, may I come inside your yard? If you allow me, can I come inside your yard?" Now, the meaning of yard is a piece of land next to a house, usually used for growing grass, flower and other plants. So now the boy describes the appearance of the man, that he was a very small man, not very tall, and he was neatly dressed. He was wearing a hat, a white shirt with black trousers. So he asked boy that, "Can I come inside your yard?" I asked, "What you want?" He said, "I want to watch your bees." We had four small grew palm trees and they were full of invited bees. I ran up the steps and shouted, Ma, it have a man outside here. He say he want to watch the bees. So the boy asks the man that what you want, and the man simply says that I want nothing, but I want to watch your bees in your yard. Now the boy tells that they were having a small, four small grew palm trees which were full of invited bees. There were many bees over that trees, over those trees. Grew palm tree is a West Indian palm tree with a spiny trunk and leaves and edible nuts. The nuts of those trees could be eaten. So after he asked his permission to come in his yard and watch the bees, he called his mother and told her that there is a man outside and he wants to come inside our yard and watch the bees. My mother came out, looked at the man and asked in an unfriendly way, what you want? The man said, I want to watch your bees. His English was so good, it didn't sound natural, and I could see my mother was worried. She said to me, stay here and watch him while he watched the bees. So my mother came down, she stared at the man. She was not happy with his arrival, and therefore in a very casual, unfriendly way, she asked the man what he wants. The man again replied that he wants nothing, but he simply wants to watch the bees. The way he was speaking, his English was very good, and it was not sounding natural. It was a very refined English, and the boy could see that his mother was very worried. So she asked the boy to be with the man till the time he is watching the bees. The man said, thank you madam, you have done a good deed today. He spoke very slowly and very correctly, as though every word was costing him money. We watched the bees, this man and I, for about an hour, squatting near the palm trees. The man said, I like watching bees. Sonny, do you like watching bees? Now, after getting the permission of being allowed of to come inside the yard and watch the bees, the man gets happy, and she thanked the lady for allowing him to come inside the yard in order to watch the bees. He was speaking very slowly and very carefully, as though for every word he was speaking, he was paying some money. So now both boy and the poet watched the bees for about an hour, squatting near the palm trees. Squatting means to sit in a low position. They were sitting near the palm trees, and they both were watching the bees for about an hour. While they were watching the bees, the man said to the boy that, I like watching bees. Do you also like watching bees?